Ayo, ayo, what's poppin', my fellow music lovers and listeners? Welcome back to Multifaceted Media Entertainment, and today I got a brand new video for you guys. Now in today's video, I'm gonna be checking out this new track, this brand new release by JID. This one is called 2007, and as far as what I've been hearing, I don't think this one is gonna be making the full project, unfortunately. And this track is 7 minutes and 26 seconds long, so hella excited to see the direction that JLD will be taking on this track over here. From the sampler, the teaser that he released on Instagram earlier today, kinda has me feeling that this is more of a story driven track, and that would kinda explain why it's 7 minutes and 26 seconds long. So without further ado, man, hella excited to check this one out. Brand new track from JLD. Unfortunately, won't be making the full project. I'm hearing that it's some sample relating issues or related issues. So yeah, man, JID 2007, let's get it.
Our offense is oh so, our defense dominates. We got that winning combination to regulate. Offense is oh so.
Yeah, 2007, cold drop to come up. I was in high school playing corner. I never dreamt of mumbling words in front of hundreds. Studying plays all summer. I'll hit the league if my growth spurt coming on my mama. 2009, bro dropped the warm up. I was in warm ups playing Wheezy and you keep me little dragon flame breathing the weed. Patrick had a studio dorm room next to me. I freestyled over his beats. My nigga Keys transferred in from Tennessee. He's a receiver. I play DB like Akeem. Snatch a nigga chain to lead. Talib Kweli, I could be lyrically, but I put on cleats, scribble lines going through my mind like.
Okay, so he's kind of using J. Cole's album release dates and tying it back to the stage that he was at in his life during those time periods, and then saying that he was mostly focusing on playing sports, on playing ball back then, instead of actually mumbling in front of mics.
Probably I could be lyrically, but I put on cleats, scribble lines going through my mind like a paper piece. While in cover three, playing nickel, doing safety reads. Watch the flats, I can rap, but I'd rather tackle and pedal back. Get a pick when my growth spurt hit. I'ma be captain, and I was around 2010, no cap. I got freshman player of the year and figured I was on track. This nigga Pat been in my ear talking about rhyming on tracks. So after practice, we recorded, then we got it on wax. And on campus, I heard about a couple rappers from Atlanta. Said them niggas be snapping, maybe we could make something happen and shit. I wasn't serious enough to even be curious. And we lose like every game, so every day I be furious. So the spirit of a nigga had changed, to the point I had to reframe and focus my skills for other things. I took the steel wheel, I'm steering in other lanes, but my fuel on low and my oil need to be changed. Amongst all the other shit that's going in my brain, my brother got out of jail, I only know him by name. He did a nickel and a dime, and time probably be staying with my mom and dad. Probably get mad, acting lame sometimes. Look. The sideline story came out September 2011. Eve said around that time
we was hunting for a record under lots of pressure. Just combine the leverage with a better effort, you can find a sound and get us out the underground forever.
Maybe you can bless a little brown effervescent kid, youngest of seven from the 6-8 section. Section 80 drop. Yeah, we used to play that shit to death. And if I
went, oh my, yo, the transition into the Section 80 instrumental, which was actually produced by J. Cole, in case y'all didn't know that. Well, yeah, love that track, and I love that transition in this track as well.
From the 6-8 section, section 80 drop. Yeah, we used to play that shit to death, and if I recollect correct, you tried to sign up for yourself. All the while I was around my.
Oh, so this is kind of a letter to J. Cole, because he's saying that if I recollect correct, you tried to sign him for yourself, because for those who don't know, J. Cole actually tried to sign Kendrick back in the day. Which is interesting.
My out of town college wildin' out. Restaurants, destined dining, dashing, call it dining out. Fucking bitches supposed to be in class, but I was hiding out. My friends take a little shot, smoke a lot of cannabis. Coolest nigga on the campus. Nine niggas skipping practices and acting like a rock star. Going from in the dorm to in the car, leaving the football field. But fuck that, we still sorry. And the problem from the home front. On my home screen, calling me, I don't wanna answer. My brother Carl hit me, said my granny had cancer. I'm supposed to graduate and make my way back to Atlanta, no job, no money or nothing from balling, because between that and school, that was really all. And maybe here's the back that broke the camel with the straw. I wasn't on camera with them amateurs that they saw, but they said they still caught me and my dog stealing boxes like Craig on his day off. Called us in the office day before we post a whopper. Called a squad car, a couple officers. I knew bro was finna tell, he was looking nauseous. Now I'm sitting in his cell, nickel double crossed us. Crossed me off the list for scholarship because I lost it. No more football, my red shirt, senior season exhausted. So I'm off it and I'm right back in Atlanta with a half a gram of weed and a gold Pontiac that my granny had bought for me. I was sleeping in the back, my dad kicked me in the streets when he saw my neck tatted. Then I told him I was rapping for school, no going back. He said, if I cannot follow his rules, just go and pack. Told you he be acting lame sometimes.
That's how fathers be, man. I can relate to that one.
This my son, he came from these nuts. This Negro come back from school, all tatted up like the Sistine Chapel, talking about.
Now this nigga actually has his father as an interlude on this thing.
He ain't playing football no more because he know he ain't going pro. He left on a full scholarship to go to school and get a degree because we taught education was the number one thing. Anyway, he came back determined to do what he was determined to do, and I know because he is who he is. We taught him, hey, whatever you do, put your full self into it. So he did that. Anyway, he's back home. I ain't with that. So I'm saying, hey, you got to go to work. And he's saying, hey, this is my job, what I'm about to do. So I'm like, hey, man, sometimes you got to work to do what you really want to do. We went through this whole
That's facts, bro.
But anyway, he won. He decided that, hey, dad, I'm putting this thing, I'm doing this. This is my job. And he committed to it. And hey, the rest is history. I'm looking at him. I believe in him. I know what was in him. All him and his brothers and sisters, they all got the same mindset. Do your best, give 100%, or don't do it at all. So I know whatever he put his all into, it was gonna be golden. Anyway,
look, March 10th, 2017, the Never Story dropped, and I'm coming off a tour with. That was 3 years after opening up for Ab Soul, but it's Earth Gang set. I only came to do a song. Dope Burger used to say, hey bro, this little nigga cold. Keep on doing what you doing, you gon' make it, you gon' blow. I ain't know that said that went ahead and played my shit for Cole, but I knew he knew the game, and he pulled up to a show, and then that's where we first met, but I ain't think of it no more. Till Sid Brown said that I should open up for Omen on my own shit if I want it. Only 4 cities, maybe we get Rob Gibbs on the phone in. I gotta hone in. In the game, grown men uncomfortable in their own skin. But all I wanted was a chance. It feel like I'm in the mannequin challenge. Still stands, but I'm still standing. Till my nigga lent a hand and I'm no longer stranded. Looking for strength in the streets of East Atlanta.
Mama said, don't
take advice. They gon' try and take advantage. I was about to sign with Coach K. I ain't take the advance. Cole say, hold on, wait, bro. I got the plan, so come on. Damn, little nigga, come on. Shit.
Yo, that's crazy.
Yo, cool world.
That's crazy. Yo, Jay, I remember you came to the crib. Remember this after we had met, and I told you and Earth Gang to pull up to the crib in Carolina. It's the studio house. I wasn't on no shit like, yo, I'm trying to do some Dreamville shit with y'all now. There wasn't no talk or no deal. I didn't even know if I wanted to sign niggas. I just knew y'all was dope. I fuck with you. Just pull up, let's see what the vibe is like, let's work. In my mind, if something happened, it happened. If not, then cool, niggas just got a chance to link and kick it. But while we was there, the thing that I noticed off rip, I said, oh, this nigga want it. This nigga really want it. That look in your eye, nigga, I know that look. I know that look too well. But a lot of niggas want it. The thing I noticed about you, my nigga, off rip, this nigga don't just want it. He willing to do the work that it takes to get it. And that's the difference. That's the separator. That's the difference between the niggas that never get what they want and the niggas whose names ring out forever.
Nice. Forever. Now, I'm even more pissed that this will not make the project, because I feel like this would be an excellent closing track for the Never Story. I mean, for the Forever Story. Just the vibe of the track, the sentiment of the track, the story that G.I.D. was telling throughout the track, I think it would be a fitting closer for an album. Obviously, I haven't heard the Forever Story yet. I don't know the content that is on there for the majority. But it just feels like a very good closing track in general to me. But yeah, man, love the story on this one. Love the way he brought his father into it to kind of tell his side of the story based on what he thought G.I.D. was doing at the time, man. And I love how he integrated J. Cole into the track as well. And excellent samples throughout the track. A lot of great beats. A lot of great beat switches. A lot of great references. And yeah, man. Just sorry that this one won't make the album. As far as I'm hearing, at least. So yeah, man. What do you guys think about the track? Please let me know in the comment section below. Are you excited for the Forever Story coming next Friday? I know for a fact that I am, man. He just released his second single from the project as well. Dance Now, reacted to that on the channel as well. Really enjoy it. So yeah, man, let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Once again, this has been Multifaceted Media, and I'm signing out.